Mr. Weinkauf with Embrace Tutoring and Educational Services. Today in this video, we will be discussing the strategy approaching quickly for practice problems, SAT, practice test 8, questions 31 through 38, math section 4. Question 31 states, there are two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen and one molecule of water. How many atoms of hydrogen are there in 51 molecules of water? Well, I see there was a 2-to-1 ratio, so 102 molecules of hydrogen exist within 50 molecules of water. Basically, I'm doing 51 times 2 to get my 2 atoms of hydrogen per molecule. Question 32. If x equals 1 in the equation above, what is the value of a? Here I have 1 minus 1 half a equals 0. Multiply the entire equation by 2 in order to eliminate the fraction. 2 minus a equals 0. If I were to add a to both sides, here I have 2 equals a. That is my answer. Moving on. Question 33. In the xy plane, the equations x plus 2y equal 10 and 3x plus 6y equals c represent the same line for the constant c. What is the value of c? Or if I were to line these up, I see that x plus 2y equal 10. Well, the relationship is that x going to 3x, I'm multiplying that by 3. 2y going to 6y, I'm multiplying that by 3 as well. So 10 multiplied by 3 should give me c, so c will be equivalent to 30. 1034, let's see, if he had ridden straight to Lexington without stopping, he would have traveled 11 miles in 26 minutes. In such a ride, what would the average speed of his horse have been to the nearest tenth of a mile per hour? So I'm taking 11 miles, and I'm going to do over 26 minutes, and I'm attempting to convert this to miles per hour. So I would want to keep miles obviously still on the top because it's within my numerator per hour. So I'm going to take my minutes here, and this becomes 11 times 60 divided by 1, and the 1 denotes the hour. The minutes will cancel. 11 times 60 divided by 26 in total. And this will end up giving me 25.4, and it will be miles per hour, which is what I just solved for. So 25.4 miles per hour. Question 35, here I'm given a large graph. The graph of the function f defined by f of x equals negative 1/2, x minus 4 to the second power plus 10 is shown xy plane. If the function g, which is not shown, is defined by g of x equals minus x plus 10, what is one possible value of a such that f of a equals g of a? Well, if f of a equals g of a, then I can simply plug these in and plug in the a's as well. So f of a equals g of a, so let's plug those in. So f of a here would be minus 1/2 times a minus 4 squared plus 10. And my g of a is going to be negative a plus 10. I immediately can take out my 10s because if I just subtract it by 10 on either side, I can kind of balance that out and take those away. I can also multiply this entire equation by 2 in order to eliminate my fraction. So I'm going to do that. All right, let's multiply the entire equation by 2. And here I get my minus 1. Actually, I'll multiply by negative 2. In order to eliminate both of these negatives. And here I get an a minus 4 squared. I'm simply just 2, negative 2 times negative 1 gives me positive 1, which is over here on the outside. I've eliminated that. A minus 4 squared, and then equals, this is a positive 2a. I can carry this through. So here I have a minus 4 and squared minus 2a equals 0. I'm going to attempt to FOIL this out rather quickly. That way I can simplify the like terms and factor back. And when I do this, I know that since both of these are negative, they will be, the middle terms will be added together, and this will become a squared minus 8a plus 16 minus 2a equals 0. I can combine my like terms. Here I end up getting my a squared minus 10a plus 16. If I were to FOIL this, given the fact there's a negative and a positive, I now have a, and let's say, minus 8, and then I also have a minus 2, and the negative 8 times the negative 2 is what gives me a positive 16. So two possible values, where it says what is one possible value of a such that f of a equals g of a. Two possible values are a equals positive 8 or a equals positive 2. I generally put in positive 2, just faster. Here we go. 6, in triangle RST. So RST here, point W, not shown, lies on RT. So this line here, point W, let's say he's here, kind of come down. What is the value of cosine RSW and sine WST? Oh, this is actually pretty simplistic, because both of these angles here are complementary to each other, meaning that they are within the 90 degree angle, or adding up to the 90 degree angle. And the rule is that when you have complementary angles, the cosine of an angle is equal to the sine, right? So the cosine of one angle is going to be equal to the sine of the complementary angle when the angles are complementary. So if these are equal, and if I'm subtracting them, then your answer will be 0 altogether. Question 37 states, according to the table, how many more micrograms of penicillin are present in 10 milliliters of blood drawn from a patient 5 minutes after the injection than are present in 8 milliliters of blood drawn 10 minutes after the injection? Well, if I click back to my table, I'll see that for 5 minutes after, I have 152 micrograms per 1 liter. That's, or per 1 milliliter is what they give me. But the individual is asking, what happens if I draw 10 milliliters of blood? I can cancel those, and here and now I have 1,520 micrograms of blood expected within my 10 milliliters of blood drawn. Likewise, if I have my 10 minutes after my injection, if I go back to my table, I see that I have 118 micrograms of penicillin present within the blood for every 1 milliliter. But we are drawing 8 milliliters of blood, so we want to attempt to kind of cancel out those units. 118 times 8 is going to be 944 micrograms, and this is for the 8 milliliters of blood. This is for the 10 milliliters of blood. The question is asking, how many more micrograms of penicillin are present in 10? Okay, good. So the value that should be higher is higher, and I'm simply going to take the difference of these values. 1,520 micrograms minus 944 micrograms, which will give me a total of 576 more micrograms within the 10 milliliters of blood, right? This should be the higher value, so 576 should be my answer for question 3. Question 38, the penicillin concentration in micrograms per milliliter in the patient's bloodstream T minutes after the penicillin injection is modeled by the function of P of T equals 200 B, and I see T over 5. If P approximates the values in the table to the 10 micrograms per milliliter, what is the value of B rounded to the nearest tenth? So I'm attempting to solve for B. And by wanting to solve for B, I see here that I have a T within my exponent. So I want to figure out a way to easily cancel these. And based upon my previous table, I remember seeing that I have a 5 in terms of my time, and then the PT, or the penicillin, referring to the time, is 152. So I'm going to plug in these values, right? My 5 here being the time, and my 152 being equal to the total amount of penicillin concentration. So I have 152 equals 200, and this is B. And the whole reason I did this was because now I have 5 over 5, which is equivalent to B to the first power, which is B. So 152 now equals 200, B to the first power, divide both sides by 200 in order to isolate and solve for B, divide both sides by 200, and my answer should be 4/5, right, equals B, or right around, I would say, 0.8 if you're rounding to the nearest tenth. So 4/5 or 0.8 should be the best answer for number 38.